I feel a lot freer. I feel a lot more self-expressed.
It feels like it gave me insight in such a short time. That's the thing I think is the key.
Because I really think this technology is the medicine of the future.
Voice mapping is a form of emotional healing that uses the frequencies in your voice in a biofeedback process. There are some scientists, neurobiologists, who believe that memory, specifically stress memory or traumatic memory, is actually stored in muscle tissue. And one thing I learned when I became a voice map practitioner is that a lot of muscles in the body are used to create the voice. I didn't know that. I thought it was just maybe the diaphragm and the voice box.
Sometimes it was a little uncomfortable.
From your thighs up through your skull, a lot of those muscles contribute to all those nuances in the voice. So if you're talking into the voice mapping microphone and you're talking about something that has a history to it, has some memory that's got some stress, wherever that memory is actually buried in tissue is activated. And then that activated memory affects the muscle. That muscle then affects the voice in terms of its contribution to the voice.
As I train actors and performers, and where they place their voice usually has an emotional resonance. And so when I first heard about it, I was very attracted to it because I thought, oh, here's a machine able to do what I kind of do with my gut.
This is a voice map. This is what shows up on the computer screen after you have made your recording. Each sector represents a different emotional condition. Blue is a low emotional intensity, green is medium, yellow is high, and red is extreme. The black areas represent the frequencies that are missing, and it's been determined that those missing frequencies are the ones connected to the trauma and the stressful memories. So when the feedback of the missing frequencies does the unlocking, which allows for the balancing and releasing of the place where those memories are buried, which then allows you to be more present instead of responding to historical memory that is no longer relevant in your life.
Literally in a session, I can have a voice map done, see the diagram and see where the blocks are, and then do the work, the processing and clearing that happens with the voice mapping process, and then see the map change in the course of a session, and then come back to it in the next session and check back in and see where things are.
Voice mapping can be used for any number of reasons. Athletes use it to overcome the blocks to achieving their personal best, overcoming procrastination. People use it to deal with their fear of public speaking. Parents often realize that they've been doing to their children behaviors that they didn't like receiving from their parents, and that's been very helpful for improving our relationships within families.
So I've had approximately 6 sessions. From the first to the current, they're just more precise and more quick, like the change happens quicker over time.
Notice that sector 11 is down, yellow is high, blue is low.
In terms of working with Matt Kramer specifically, I find his style to be very supportive. He just has the capacity to create a safe space, to explore and be vulnerable to the issues, because those are their core issues that you're dealing with in voice mapping.
He has a way of being compassionately there and invisible at once.
He tells you right off the bat, you know, he's not a shrink, you know, he's not a therapist, he's a mediator, which he's there to get a dialogue going with yourself.
Something that prior to the start of the session felt very heavy and very limiting, and then a shift happens where it seems much lighter and there's a lot more, what I experience personally is more compassion.
Well, when I say balance and release, I look at the body as basically a matrix of frequencies.
But it's the fact that you know that you're discharging something and it's that familiar, that's why it's powerful, because you realize why you couldn't get to it through therapy, or you couldn't get through it to thinking about it, or going to India about it, or whatever, you know, trying to enlighten yourself to get over it when the body is so much wiser and it did it so much quicker.
You know, a lot of thoughts came up about different parts of my life that haven't really thought of until now.
And my daughter, who's 10, and she did it, she enjoyed the music. She, you know, you have your eyes closed when you're doing the eye thing with the light. Hers is immediate, and it's an energetic thing with her, and I can see the difference. And she asked to go back.
Compared to when you sat down, how are you feeling?
I know it's kind of cliche, but I feel good. Yeah. I feel good.
It's so easy to release it because the body's doing it, not the mind. See, I think the mind is what creates a lot of suffering on top of this stress that the body is registering. So
what I got, it was a big gift in a little package of time.
I'm definitely going to continue with the voice mapping. It's a journey that's helping me reach my potential. It's helping me grow and to be more emotionally free. And so it makes room for a lot more fun and more possibility.